I'm Xavier Data. I'm a sophomore in the Village School, and for the director series, I'm using my short horror story film, and in that film, it's basically, if you want to know the narrative, it's basically a short story. You'd be like, a student is moving into a ghost room in the school, and as the story occurs, a lot of horror type events happen. For the horror festival for our school, I was really proud with our work. We put a lot of time and effort into making sure it's like the best it can be capable of. For the practical effects, for the film at least, we usually just like had one person behind the camera where they wouldn't be seen to demonstrate the spooky effect in our film. And for the computer effects, really, we didn't really use that many in our film. We mostly used probably like jump cuts and some sound to create some suspense in our film. Join Mr. Manning's film production class. It's really fun.
Be scared. Come with me.
Hannah, I'm in grade 9 and I'm going to be talking about the very first project we did, the narrative short. Okay, well, for this project, we were all working in groups because it was like our first time in this class, and the main objectives for this project, as recalling from memory, was that, well, it was our very first time in this class like working together and creating a short story, so the whole like objective of it was to first off like create a story, but also have that story have like a main plot, like a beginning, middle, end, a climax, and us just get familiar with editing and just the whole film process. Our idea for this story was a way of like an endless hallway where it really depended on our editing skills to make it work, which I do think it translated well. Although looking back at it now, I feel like we could have like went back and like enhanced it better with all the like tips and tricks we've learned. But so we had like an endless hallway idea, and the story centered around our main character, and she was running late to class one day, and then she stumbled upon this like classroom, and when she went in, she came out of the door and found that no matter how many doors she went into, she would end up in that same hallway, creating like a sense of panic, stress, but like also it was a very like quiet movie, quiet film. There was barely any dialogue, so it really depended on our like scenery, our like the setting of the story and the editing, and that was like the whole point of it. And then at the end, the person does manage to escape, but it has a very like, the story is up to interpretation for the viewer to figure out what happened, because we left the ending like open to interpretation. Visual storytelling for me, as like someone that just started getting into film, is basically a way for the person making the film, the director and the editors, to translate their ideas through simply what the viewer can see, not through text, not through dialogue, but simply what the person can view, what the viewer is seeing, what they interpret the story as. And I think like the main goal of that is ideally for the director and the viewer to see the same story.
Yeah. Jacob P, 9th grade, and we're doing a scary project. It's kind of based off of the Dahmer show, not exactly, but you know, since it was popular at the time, me and my partner decided to go that way. So the initial judges was kind of like a scary project, kind of to, you know, get people on their feet or something like that. Not necessarily say it did it, but it was kind of a scary project, and we knew that people don't really like a person like Dahmer, so it kind of went that way, and it was in the middle of scary and not scary, but kind of terrifying at the same time once you look at that person. That's probably what I'll say. First project we did, it was just, I didn't really even take it that serious until I actually started kind of having fun. I thought it was going to be, this class was going to be more of like a joke type of thing for me to do until I realized it was, oh, it's actually kind of fun. So I actually took it a little bit more serious. And then when I got to that project, I kind of knew what kind of, how to act and how to, at least better in how to do certain things in the actor role. So I think it's, yeah, it's, I think it was project number three or four that we did. And I really feel excited about that project.
I think I'm being
Hey, Mr. Manning, can I finish my project?
Yeah, Mr. Manning, I'm done.
Alright, let's see here.
What are you doing, Jacob? Come help me. Jacob, come back.
I'm Hari Manaju. Everyone might know me as Ari. I'm in 9th grade, and the project I'll be talking about is the silent film, The Music Man. When we were thinking of a silent film for, like, when we were trying to come up with an idea, we decided to infuse music into a silent film, which is not really, it's more like an oxymoron, right? And we thought it would be, like, a really creative idea, and that's why we kind of, you know, used that idea as The Music Man. Few scenes, we tried to use this almost transition, or, like, a panning shot where we would have the filming someone who's like in a more tightish space, and as he starts to progress throughout the scene, it would start to almost start to widen out, and it's like in transition with the music and the music's increasing in volume and decrease. So we diffused that aspect inside of our editing and our filming. Technique that we used was the lighting. We try and like dim out the lighting in some places where the music isn't that loud and prominent, but in like other areas where the music's beat is like super high up and loud, we'd have the color and the lighting start to increase slowly.
One, two, three, ho! Get your funky soul. They're doing it down in that song. funky soul. They're doing it by the beach. They're driving that funky soul. New York, get yourself together and drive your funky soul. Let your body pop and let your feeling flow. Raise up, get yourself together and drive that funky soul. When I say Sagittarius, drive that funky soul.
My name is Cole, I'm a freshman, and the project I chose was a remix project, and so I basically took a scene from Ford vs. Ferrari and I remixed it into my own thing. The premise was to take a scene or parts from movies that you like and film your own scenes for it that basically go along the storyline of the movie that you chose. The film I chose was Ford vs. Ferrari, and it basically tells the story of Ford trying to beat Ferrari at 24 Hours of Le Mans. I really like matching music with the scenes that I'm working on. I think it adds a lot of depth to my work.
Thank you.
I'm Alex Efimenko, I'm in grade 9, and I'm introducing a scary movie project called 3AM. We decided to do a, so this was the scary movie project, and we decided to make it funny and not that scary. I was trying to act like a YouTube, like one of those fake 3AM YouTubers. I would say guys every 2 seconds in the video. I think when we were recording, we went really well, because we, had like a script and a story, and we stick to it. When usually we don't stick to it, we usually deviate from it. I felt way more confident going into this project because we already done 2 other projects, and I think my skills have improved.
Guys, today we're calling Bob the Menace at 3 a.m. Look, guys, Bob the Menace is calling us. Let's pick up the phone. Bob, is that really you? Oh my God, guys, he's actually real? Guys, someone's knocking at the door. Cameraman, go open it.
There's no one here.
My cameraman is missing. He won't answer any of my phone calls. I'm gonna go downstairs and check it out myself. Guys, my cameraman's door to be seen. Thank God I haven't paid him yet. Guys, I'm gonna go outside. Guys, now I'm outside. Oh my God, guys, there's someone behind me. Guys, I'm currently getting chased. Guys, I'm currently dying to the monster. He's dragging me somewhere. Please like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell, and I'll hopefully see you in the next video. Bye.
So for me, the project that I'm gonna be talking about today is the remix project I'm currently working on that I haven't just finished yet. So my name is Nabil, I'm a freshman. I take all of it, I'm a director, I'm an editor, I'm a main actor. I'm also main editor and main director and main storyboard writer and main writer, script writer. So I do all of it. I'm probably like the type of director that would take like the peer's job. So I would make sure I'm able to do like all of these before giving the job to other people. About the remix project that I'm making. So the remix project has a lot of things from the past previous years that we learned about this class. So we learned about like the arrays and type of where to put the person and the where to put the camera on. Not only do you get to learn where to put the camera, we can also learn where to put the person at and where to put the how to put the background and the color grading, and also how to edit the videos. So for my remix project, you guys may have known of the series called Moon Knight. It's on Disney Plus. It's one of my favorite series because it has a lot of cinematic moments. And I just really love cinematic moments and cinematic music. Like epic music is very cool. I love it so much that I put like some of the music into my project. Not a copyrighted ones, fair use ones. So in this project, you guys may have known like the pyramid scene. So we tried to do that, but with a school. So like the drone. So next semester, you guys have the time, make sure to join this class.
I had no loving arms to hold me. Every day I wake up, then I start to break up. Lonely as a man without love. Every day I start out, then I cry my heart out. Lonely as a man.
When I was born, I had powers my parents could even explain. Even to the extent where I can even change my skin. The next thing I knew, I was being chased by creatures I didn't even know existed. But this school is different. I don't know about it, but I just have this feeling. But there's just some things I can't even explain. But even as though I'm chased, I guess I'll live with it.
Okay, so my name is Shiksha Mohan and I'm in grade 9. The project I chose was project number 2, the silent movie project. So basically the silent movie project was we had to make a movie where there wasn't any dialogue or almost no dialogue and or sound for that matter. So my idea was that to use a kind of a world where only the main character can hear sound. And it's kind of tripping them off, it's making them confused because nobody else can seem to hear what they hear. What I enjoy most is making like B-rolls or like introduction shots and really like getting angles that would like introduce the watcher into the space that we're making the movie.